Today I'm going to show you how to create a Facebook business page from start to finish, so let's jump right into it. Hi everyone, my name is Samantha and I am the social media specialist here at Rescue Marketing. First, let's start by logging into your personal Facebook account. Every business page has to have a personal Facebook account connected to it. Once you're logged in, head over to the menu button and select Pages from the slider bar. Here you can click Create New Page. If there is a pop-up, make sure to select Public Page to create a business profile and then click Get Started. Next, you will be brought to a screen that looks similar to this one. Keep in mind that Meta is constantly updating their user interface, so some features may look slightly different depending on when you are watching this video. For this tutorial, we are going to use a fake business named the Curious Cat Bookshop, which is a fake local bookstore in Chicago, to explain the process of creating a Facebook business page. Here is where you will input your business information. Your page name should be your business name. From the options, choose the industry that best relates to your company and what you offer. In this example, we will be choosing bookstore from the search. The last step in this section is to add a company bio. Here you should explain who you are, what you offer, any company slogans, but be sure it isn't within their limits of 101 characters, so you might have to get a little creative with your words. Now it's time to add your contact information and basic company info. To start, let's add a website and phone number along with your company email that you are okay with customers contacting you by. If you have a physical address, you will also need to add it here. It is important to have accurate, up-to-date business hours so customers know when they can access your location, product, or services. As you'll see, Facebook shows you how healthy your page is, which is a great feature. You want it to be as high as possible, so keep an eye on it as it changes throughout the page setup. Once all of this is filled out, you can click on Next. This section of the Facebook business page setup allows you to upload a profile picture and a cover photo. Your profile image is here, and it should be clear. Ideally, you would want to use your brand logo. And your cover image is over here, and it should be representative of your brand. Our team recommends using Canva for the cover image if you need some design help. They offer a ton of different properly sized templates for cover images on Facebook to make it easy for you. Before moving on, here are the recommended Facebook profile and cover image sizes. Another important part of your Facebook business page is the action button, which is your call to action, which basically means what do you want customers to do when they leave your page? You have many options to choose from, and you ideally will pick what is best for your business. To start, you could choose from Book Now, Sign Up, Start Order, View Shop, or Get Tickets. You can also have a button to encourage people to contact you, like Send Message, Send WhatsApp Message, Call Now, Send Email, or Contact Us. They also allow you to use a link to your group or app, which could be Learn More, Watch Now, Visit Group, Play Game, Buy Now, or Reserve. For our fake business, we are going to choose Learn More so that when customers click the button, it takes them directly to our website. Whichever button you choose, fill in the appropriate information that they are asking for and click Next. If your company uses WhatsApp, this is where you can add your WhatsApp phone number. For our example, we are going to skip this section. And finally, the last step in creating your Facebook business page is to invite your personal friends on Facebook to like and follow your page. Although you may want to invite everyone you know, it is recommended to invite those who are likely to use your product or service and who align with your company target audience. Since this is an example page, we are not going to invite our friends to like the page and follow. Now that your Facebook business page is set up, let's take a look at some key features within Facebook's platform. Under Manage Page, here's where you can post on your Facebook page, view your page, and access important information and settings. If you are not using the Meta Business Suite, this is where you will likely spend most of your time. Now let's dive into the Manage Page dashboard. The first important feature on this page is that you can edit your business information like website, profile and cover image, bio, and more. The second key feature is the ability to post on your Facebook page. Simply navigate to the What's on Your Mind text bubble and it will ask you what type of post you want to create. From there, you can upload your media text and choose any applicable add-ons. You can then post it immediately, or you can schedule it to publish at a later date and time through the Meta Business Suite. Now let's move on to the left side of your screen. Here is where you will find the professional dashboard, insights, ad center, the ability to create ads, boost Instagram posts, settings, and more tools. The professional dashboard we will go over shortly. Insights is where you can access analytics about your posts and Facebook page. In the ad center, you will have access to past and current ads, along with an overview of your ads so you have a better understanding of the money being spent and your ad performance. Create ads is exactly what it sounds like. Here you can run paid ads using your Facebook page to target your audience to reach a specific goal. If you have an Instagram and it is connected to your Facebook account, the Boost Instagram Posts tab allows you to select a post on Instagram to boost it, aka pay to have it reach more people. The settings we will also go over shortly. Under More Tools, you can access more Meta tools like their Lead Center, Meta Business Suite, which we will cover in the next video, and the Nonprofit Manager. Aside from the Meta Business Suite, these tools are designed for specific types of companies, so we will not be covering them in this video. Now let's dive into the Professional Dashboard. When you open the Professional Dashboard, you will see a page overview. Here you can see some post performance insights, recent content posted, tips to finish your page, new pages guide, and frequently asked questions. Jumping into insights, this section is where you will be able to analyze and see page and post performance. Like the page overview, the home section is a general overview of your insights. Your page shows key data like post reach and engagement, types of engagement, page likes, and follower increase. The content section breaks down each individual post and its performance. You can also create a post from this section and boost posts that have already been published. The audience tab shows you important follower data, but only once you have reached 100 followers. Under Grow Your Audience, you have access to the Ad Center and the ability to invite people to like your page like we did in the initial page setup. In the Professional Dashboard, you can access Meta tools like Levels Progress, Achievements, Inspiration for Future Posts. You can also manage comments on your Facebook page, see event insights, and create new events. Page access is an important setting for businesses. Here you can provide Facebook users access to manage your Facebook business page. You can see here that we have full access to this page since we created it. Only allow full access to those that you trust and are close to your company. To add a user, simply click on Add New and search up their Facebook profile. If you want to provide people with partial access, you can add them here as a community manager. The process is the same for both levels of access. Going back to the professional dashboard, I want to show you their A/B testing feature. Here, Facebook allows you to post multiple versions of a video post to see which performs better. This is great for beginning to understand your audience's preferences and their behavior on Facebook. Scrolling past the moderation assist, under linked accounts, you can link your Instagram and WhatsApp account. Simply click on view and follow the steps to connect the accounts. Page recommendations is a great place to see more information on how to optimize your Facebook business page and check on the status of your account in terms of violation. You can access the Meta Business Suite from the professional dashboard, which we will discuss in a future video, but here's a quick glimpse at the dashboard. The last feature of the professional dashboard I want to point out is the inbox. The inbox allows you to manage and answer comments and messages. They have a cool feature called automations where you can create auto responses when someone DMs your account. Some of the automations are instant reply, away message, unanswered messages, custom keywords, contact information, hours, locations, and comment to message. These are great if you are a one-person team handling social media for your brand or client's brand. Last in the professional dashboard is some more resources to help you with your Facebook business page if needed. Now let's jump into account settings. There are a few key settings that I want to go over with you. You can access the settings by going to the Manage Page section and clicking on Settings. The first section in Settings is your preferences. Here is where you can manage your more personal preferences, like if you want to see the number of likes on posts, how and where you want to receive account notifications, app accessibility, how to see video content, and if you want to switch to dark mode. Page details will take you to your Facebook page to update the company information like your website and hours. You can choose how people can find and contact you. We recommend having all three turned on so that Google can access your page, your page can be recommended, and that potential customers can message you directly. For posts and stories, this is where you can control who can see your posts and how they can engage with them. Under page setup, a key feature about this is you can go to name and set your username. You should use your company name so that the link to your Facebook page shows as your name versus a random numerical URL. This allows users to find you much easier. Also in page setup, you can control page access, which we discussed earlier, see management history and page edits, check on page statuses, see recommendations to improve your page, along with a few other features that we're not going to touch on today. Followers and public content allows you to control who sees what's on your page. Since this is a business account, it is by default public. You can control who can comment and if there are any restrictions you want to add to the comments posted by others. This is great for flagging harmful or inappropriate comments before they are made public, and you can also control age and country restrictions here. Page and tagging allows you to control who can post on your page, who can see those posts on your page, and additional page privacy settings to better monitor what others are doing in relation to your company. I like to have reviewing settings all turned on. You can also manage accounts and pages you have blocked in settings and privacy. The settings is another section where you can link your Instagram and WhatsApp account to your Facebook. If you want to delete or temporarily deactivate your account, you can do so under Access and Control. And that is about it for the Facebook settings and privacy section. Before closing out this tutorial, even if you have no plan on running ads at the moment or using Facebook, it is highly recommended that you set up a business portfolio and ads account through the Meta Business Suite. If your business is interested in more digital marketing tutorials, our team has color-coded our thumbnails and organized our videos into playlists. For more information regarding our services, head to our website and leave any questions or concerns in the comments below.